Hello, welcome. This is I was planning. So first of all, let me introduce myself. I'm Scott Gumbar, part owner of Rooftop Marketing. I'm the chief marketing officer there, SEO expert. Google my name. Speaking of SEO, Google my name and you'll see what I do. The reason for this is I was going to write a blog post about the anatomy of a Google search page, but I decided instead to record a video. So that maybe that'll help the businesses out there. So Rooftop Marketing specializes in marketing for service businesses like, let's say, plumbers, as you see on the screen, or roofers or electricians, home improvement, mostly home improvement, but a few other service industry businesses. And what I get is a lot of questions about how the Google search results work, what's coming in the future. So I wanted to do a quick video. And we'll transcribe it, of course, and have it listed on our website, rooftopmarketinggroup.com. Okay, so now to the meat and potatoes of our show, of our video. This is the Google search results page. And I searched for plumber. Now, the plumbers in Meriden, Connecticut, plumbers near me, these are suggestions, but I'm going to tell you, plumbers in Meriden, Connecticut probably doesn't get a lot of searches, right? And the way Google works today is that instead of putting in plumber and getting a Google page of the what is believed to be the what would be the pages that the websites that have the best SEO, that is not necessarily true anymore. What do I mean by that? So first of all, let's go through the different sections. So on the very top, you have Google Guaranteed. Google Guaranteed is a program where these plumbers are vetted, and then Google, you click on this, and the call goes straight to that plumber in this case. And you get a plumber who's been vetted by Google. They have insurance, they're licensed, et cetera, et cetera. They have reviews. As you can see, this plumber, particular plumber, has a 4.8. review rating. And the idea behind this is that Google says, okay, these plumbers are legitimate and they do a good job, and you can rest assured that if they come in your house, that you will get the job done right. And then there's more plumbers. You can click on that and you'll see more plumbers. They pay about, I think on average, about $35 per lead. The great thing about this is that the lead is a hot lead. They're calling you directly. They're not calling Advanced Plumbing and Roto-Rooter Plumbing over here. I'm not sure why. I don't know if that's a franchise. So they're not calling two different Roto-Rooter Plumbings. They're not calling Advanced Plumbing. They're calling the one they click on. And we have clients that are using this with great success, more than adequate ROI on that, return on investment on that, okay? Below that, so this is part of the Google Ads system. It's Google Local Ads, but they appear on top. Below that, this is part of Google, what used to be AdWords. This is now Google Ads. So you'll see Roto-Rooters here. You'll see Roto-Rooters here. Three different numbers. Could be a little bit of a concern for me that probably is a franchise. I think it is. But I would be a little, you know, that's a big SEO problem, having three different locations, three different numbers. But it doesn't impact ads. So these are the regular ads. These are Google AdWords, or Google Ads. It's no longer called AdWords. They're just Google Ads. And you set up these ads, and then you target, you know, specific areas and so forth. Below this is, and you may see up to four ads above what this is, which is called the Map Pack, the three pack, Google Maps. It's got a Google Local, Google My Business. This is all set up through Google My Business. And again, you can run an ad. It doesn't look like anybody is here, but you can run an ad here as well. And now you have the option. So they call it the three pack because you only see three, but now you have the option to sort by rating or by the hours. So maybe you have an emergency on a Sunday afternoon and you need someone, you can sort by that. And you can see here, you have these are the ones that are closest to me that appear to be active. as you can see, the hours, M&M services on Gracie Ave, which is right around the corner for me, but I'm not familiar with that service. So Google My Business sets all this up. Now, with Google My Business, you also get, if I search for a specific business, I'll also get more features, including message them directly from the Google Business listing if they have it set up, and leave a review and so forth. Then you have the organic listing. So there's four opportunities here. I have Google Guaranteed, Google Ads, Google Map Pack, 3-pack, and then organic listings. And this is what SEO does. Now, SEO experts will also do this, Google My Business, and many of them will also run ads. We run ads. We do all of it. Okay. And then, so what you see here is you'll see Yelp, 10 Best Plumbing in Meriden. So if your SEO marketer or whoever knows what they're doing, they're setting you up on Yelp as well. You have Home Advisor. We'll discuss Home Advisor in another video. You have Angie's List. We'll probably discuss that in the same video, and Better Business Bureau. But then you have Affordable Plumbing Services. This is a local, I'm in Meriden, Connecticut, so a local plumber. It's not a nationwide plumbing chain. It's not, it's not some big name. It's not Roto-Rooter that you saw up above. So you can compete on the first page of Google for what we call a high value keyword. Plumber is a very high value keyword. I don't have to put in plumber in Meriden. I don't have to put in plumber near me. Below them, you have Advanced Plumbing. Looks like they're in the Middletown area, which is one town above me. Advanced Plumbing again. 10 Best Plumbers Near Me. Home Guide, which, you know, I'm not too familiar with Home Guide, but maybe that's another place you can list your site. Duane Plumbing, which has, it says Meriden. Okay. Meriden, Connecticut. This is Roto-Rooter. But, yeah, Roto-Rooter. So, same one. Let me see. 2350100. So, it looks to me like Roto-Rooter has some work to do, but that's just my opinion. So, Roto-Rooter. Advanced Plumbing and Heating again. So, they're on the first page of Google for plumbers three times under organic, Home Advisor again, and then finally Decola's Plumbing, which has, this is an ad. So Google Ads will finish up at the bottom of the first page as well. And then I would keep going. However, what happens on Google is that most people don't go past the first page. Some estimate that more than 90% don't go past the first page. But now let's look at painters. And again, I'm going to tell you a story real quick about a painter, a local painter, you know, about a half hour north of here, who wanted to be found because of his marketer's recommendation, wanted to be found for commercial painting in West Hartford, Connecticut. And I told the painter that, you know, nobody searches for that. They search for painter or commercial painter or painters or home painters, something like that. Something much more general. So here we go again. But notice now there's no Google Guaranteed. You have ads. And I discourage people from trying to compete with Home Advisor and ads, because Home Advisor has a ton of money. Now, if you're doing hyperlocal, great. You can do that and you might be able to beat them. But if you're doing a service area, you know, like a 25, 30 mile radius, I wouldn't try to compete with them. Now, that doesn't mean you can't get in the top four and then with a creative ad beat Home Advisor. That can absolutely, absolutely happen. You might spend a few dollars. The other one is Thumbtack, also has some money behind them. Quality Local Pros and Painters in My Area. So these are all listing sites. Then you have Google My Business. So those, there's no Google Guaranteed. Now you only have three opportunities, because painters cannot use Google Guaranteed yet. I imagine that's coming, but not yet. So you have your local 3-pack again. Not a lot of reviews apparently, but you can search by time that they're open, hours of operation. And by the way, this is why it's really important to have hours of operation on your Google My Business listing. There's some news stories. So this is not the type of painter we're looking for. Digital art. So maybe we would need, but then, so you see Corel Digital and digital art. These are painting. This is software and this, yeah, these are both for Corel. So these are, this is software. But then you have 10 best painters in Meriden. This is on Yelp. Painters in CT. This is an actual company. Painters Plus on Home Advisor. Angie's List. Wiktionary. Wikipedia, painting contractors near Meriden, Connecticut on BBB. So now let's try that again. Let's try commercial painter. Or let's try home painter. Okay, so now Home Advisor, Thumbtack, local painter quotes, and quality local pros, all ads, all probably listing sites. Fresh Home Painting, Painters Plus, and Franklin Painting. So now we do have ratings because there's two there. Looks like there's two there with reviews. Yelp, Painters in Connecticut, Home Advisor, BBB, Facebook, Thumbtack. This is a reason. Edwin Cordero Painting LLC. This is a good reason. And this is actually not too far from me. Great reason to have a Facebook page. His Facebook page is listed on the first page of Google. Handy.com, amazing interior painters. Not sure if that's a listing site or not. MDF Painting is an ad. So this is a Meriden. Looks like it's probably, nope, Stanford, sorry. Meriden, Connecticut on Angie's List. Ronald's Painting, CT. Not a lot of painters, and maybe there's just not a lot of painters in Meriden. So let's try Painter in Meriden. Okay. Thumbtack, quality local pros, local painting pros, Yelp, Home Advisor. Maybe there's just not a lot in Connecticut. It doesn't look like there is. Yellow Book, Porch, Angie's List, Thumbtack. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's a lot of painters in Meriden specifically. You know, the Google business listings, maybe they just, you know, this one does have a website. Oh, that's Edwin Cordero again. So I should be talking to him because, well, there you go. That's why. So that's the anatomy of a Google page, a Google local listing, a Google search results page. Now I'm going to show you one other thing. Let's put in, let's go back to plumber and let's put in who shows up organically here. Affordable plumbing. So let's put that in, and that might not search well, but plumbing. And what you're going to see, okay, that's exactly what I wanted. So what you're going to see is now that I've searched for a specific plumber, I now have their Google listing page with phone number that I can click on and call if I was on my phone. You can do it on here via Hangouts or Google Voice if you have that. The number of reviews they have, you can see a kind of quick synopsis of the reviews. They have questions, something that nobody should ever ignore. So this business, what could be the problem as the water when turned on can't be shut off and shower pole does engage. So I'm not sure, you know, probably not, I'm not sure if this is a current client or not, but they were looking for an answer, not something I would answer on Google, but I would say, can you give us a call and we'll be happy to help you out. But don't ignore those. So that's also important. You can see people also search. If I was on my mobile, you would be able to send a message if they have that set up. So lots of great features on the Google local listing. That, with that being said, you'll notice that on, so if let's go back to plumber, you'll notice that there is a big white space over here now. It used to be ads. Those are gone. But what if I asked a question? How do I fix a leaky toilet? Okay. Well, okay, so it didn't happen here, but you can see below the Google guaranteed. So sometimes it shows up over here. But you can see in the Google guarantee, replacing a damaged wax ring. And it gives instructions on how to fix it. This is a great opportunity. And this is a recent article, November 3rd of this year. So 15 days ago. The spruce. This is not, I've never heard of this website, but this is a great opportunity for your website to show up at the very top of Google. Now, why am I pointing this out? If I were to use Alexa or Google Voice, my Google Voice, sorry, I have an Alexa in the background. But if I were to use one of those smart speakers to ask this question, how do I fix a leaky toilet? This is the answer I might get, especially if I was using the Google Home speaker. Okay. I apologize for my Alexa being annoying right now. And then you'll see videos, another great way to reach people, hence the reason I'm creating a video. You'll see, people also ask. So this is where your SEO company should come in and say, okay, so how will people find us? And there's a lot of ways to figure out how to do that. There's tools available out there and so forth. But this is a great way to show up on the first page at the very top. This is called a featured snippet, by the way. Or we just call it snippets. So we can create those on your website. We can create that on your website. Okay. So you could create a video, put it on your website, but also on YouTube. There's some changes coming to YouTube too, so be aware of that. You can create, so these are all on the first page, how to fix a leaky toilet. So I wanted to give you a rundown of the anatomy of a Google search results page. People come to Google and they're going to either search for one term. Let's try roofer just so you get an idea. So here we have roofers, and our Getta is works with rooftop marketing. So I think we're doing our job there. You see the Google guaranteed. You see the Google ads. You see last 90 days. Okay, so it's giving me my search results for just roofer in the last 90 days. That's interesting. Google My Business. And then the local listings, right? So, and these are all very local to me, very hyper-local. Obviously besides Home Advisor and Wikipedia and Porch. And that's how the Google search page works. With that being said, I forgot where I was going with that. Oh, let's ask a roofer question. So how about this? Let's stick with the leak theme. How do I fix a leak in my roof? And you would answer you would get answers. So here you go. There's a couple of ads, right? There's some Google shopping ads over here. So products. And then here you have WikiHow. Kind of hard to compete with the wikis of the world, but you get the idea. This is how they're giving you some ideas of what you can do to fix it. Now, would I recommend anybody go on the roof? Absolutely not. Not unless you know what you're doing. So even with this, I would still not do it. So that's the rundown of the anatomy of a Google search page. It's evolving because now Google is using the snippets more. Now Google, so best blog ideas are ask and answer. Now Google uses structured data rather than meta keywords. Keywords have been gone for a long time, but meta description, those things, Google still uses those, but there's a chance they're going to pull whatever information they want rather than the meta description you put in. So it's using more structured data now. And so you have to, and voice search, of course, is becoming much bigger than it used to be. So you have to plan accordingly. You have to plan your SEO for today and advertising for today, but also plan for tomorrow because it's going to change again. Google's going to update again, and you're going to have to adjust or lose lots of traffic as many, many, many businesses have done with the most recent Google search algorithm update. So this is our website. In case you have more questions, I am Scott Gumbar, of course. This is rooftopmarketinggroup.com. We do have a new home improvement business builder seminar coming up. It is scheduled in Meriden this time, so Central Connecticut. If you're out there, come visit us. And I plan on doing more videos like this, and so does my partner. So, you know, be ready to learn some more. Hope this helps. Thanks, everyone.